The big bell out there. As we pull away from the station, folks, do me a big favor. Look over to the right side of the train. Give a big wave to Mike, our station master out there. All together in a big loud voice, everybody say goodbye, Mike. Beautiful. Thank you so much. Oh, nailed that first try. We sure appreciate your enthusiasm. Mike is indeed a hardworking station master here at Nairobi today. See you later, Mike. Folks, if you look over to the right side of the train, you'll see those cute little African penguins swooping around out there. They are indeed African penguins, and warm weather does not bother them. They're used to it. Not the usual cold weather penguins we think about. That's very adorable. Then over to the left side of the train, we have the eagle roll across the track, and of course, it's 6 feet 100. Also, to the left side of the train, just beyond the tree line, is the edge of Africa. Now, that's a self-guided tour. You'll get to see how pride of African lions, spotted hyenas, lemurs, and meerkats. There's also a 225,000-gallon observation tank where you'll actually get to watch the hippopotamus at play underwater. Right beside the hippo tank is a 15-foot Nile crocodile, big fella. Hands and arms inside the train, folks. Coming up on the right side of the train, the big white building is the Serengeti Overlook Restaurant. On the lower levels there, you can enjoy some nice snack items, pizza slices, roast beef sandwiches, things like that. They do have inside dining, but it's a beautiful day. You may want to sit out at the various picnic tables out there on the veranda. Enjoy your meal watching the animals that play up over the treetops out there on the Serengeti Plain. By the way, they do have a full-service bar in that restaurant as well for those of age. We're now coming into the Egypt area of the park, which happens to be home to a couple of our roller coasters. The very first one of them is the newest addition to the coastal inventory here at Busch Gardens, and that is Cobra's Curse. Cobra's Curse is a one-of-a-kind, family-friendly spin coaster. Family-friendly does not go upside down. It does, however, spin freely during a portion of your ride. Another part of it, you will be going backwards. Cobra's Curse also features a vertical lift and elevator, if you will.
It'll take you about 70 feet up in the air. Just as you come off the elevator up there, you will be face to face with an 80-foot snake icon. Cobra's Curse.
Next up on the right side of the train, the blue and beige roller coaster track, ladies and gentlemen, is the Muntu. The Muntu is one of the tallest and fastest inverted steel coasters in the southeast. Inverted simply meaning you're suspended below the tracks. It is floorless, so your legs and feet will be dangling in the air. Muntu takes you 150 feet up. It'll travel about 65 miles an hour. And it features 7 inversions, meaning you'll go upside down 7 times during the ride. Muntu is consistently ranked right up there among the top 10 coasters in the country. At this point, ladies and gentlemen, we are crossing out onto the Serengeti Belt. Please keep in mind, the animals out here are indeed wild animals. They are free roaming, so we never know where they'll be and what they'll do. And they always have the right of way, so once again, it is extremely important you remain seated at all times, keeping all body parts inside the train. Of course, you can take as many pictures as you would like, but please do that from a seated position only. Thank you so much. Giraffes on both sides of the train as we continue around the bamboo, folks. Reticulated giraffes from Bull Run, the male can be 18 feet tall, weighing up to 1 ton apiece. And they are one of the few animals to perceive color. They also have a 360-degree field of vision. Yeah, it looks like the one that was on the right is going to change his mind and go over to the left. So again, stay seated, folks. We may have to come to a stop here. Check out the zebras over on the left side of the train, ladies and gentlemen.
You'll notice their stripes stop at their shoulder line, giving them a snow-white belly. Those are Grevy's zebras. They are the largest of the zebra species. When they're first born, their stripes are tan and darken as the animal ages. The cute little tan animals over to the left side of the train are female impala. Now, when these ladies are startled in the wild, they can scatter in all directions at once, even leaping over one another in leapfrog fashion to confuse and elude their predators, and they can actually run about 55 miles an hour. Female impala. Stay seated, folks. Stay seated, please. Excellent view of the zebras out here now. By the way, going back to our reticulated giraffes, they can lie down when they want to, but they can actually do everything from the standing position. They can sleep while standing. That, of course, enables a quicker getaway in case of danger. But they also have to give birth standing up, so therefore a newborn giraffe's welcome to the world is a 6-foot drop straight to the ground. We now cross onto the north belt of the Serengeti. A few different animals out here. Check out the birds over on the left side of the train. Black wings, white chest, red head. Caribou storks. They're considered the garbage men of the Serengeti. They don't eat about anything while they're dead. Look at these zebras way over to the left side of the train, folks. You'll quickly notice the difference in the striping pattern between these are Grant's zebras and the Grevy zebras we saw over on the other side. Grant's zebra stripes are much wider, further apart, especially around the rump area, and they do go all the way around the animal's body. Because of that, they're perhaps the most photographed of the zebra species. In amongst the zebras out there to the left in the shade of that tree, looks like it's growing out the side of the hill, are some shaggy gray animals. Those are wildebeests. Now, they're also known as the white-bearded gnu. During migration, wildebeests have been known to travel in herds greater than a million strong, creating a dust cloud actually visible from the International Space Station. By the way, a newborn wildebeest can stand and run with the rest of the herd in from 3 to 7 minutes after it's born. Cute little tan animals out there with the black racing stripe along their sides are Grant's gazelles. Grant's gazelles. As we continue around the bend, we're going to have several species of animals. Look like they're going to be on the right as we go around the bend. We do have a crash. Now, a group of white rhino is actually called a crash. So as we continue around the bend here, we'll be a bit closer to them. You'll see them over to the right. White rhino, when full grown, 4,000 to 6,000 pounds apiece. Don't let that size fool you. They can still run 35 miles an hour. And even at that weight and speed, they are quite agile in tight spaces. They can stop or turn on a dime if need be. The horns on the end of their noses, folks. No bones made of the same material as our human fingernails, keratin. And they have absolutely no medicinal value whatsoever. Check out those beautiful tan animals over on the right side of the train with the very large ears, white stripes up and down their sides. Greater Kudu. We have several young ones in the mix out there. Greater Kudu, considered the most handsome of the antelope species. And of course, those large ears do give them a keen sense of hearing. When startled in the wild, they can stand perfectly still, barely moving a muscle, till the danger passes, then take off running in the opposite direction. Those thin stripes on their sides give them excellent camouflage in the tall grasses in their natural habitat. Usually up on the right side of the train, we'll have a couple of our female redneck ostriches. It's usually where they hang out. We also have another of our white rhino up there. Now, female redneck ostriches, when full grown, 9 feet tall, 340 pounds apiece. And of course, they're flightless, but they can actually run at an amazing 42 miles an hour. They only have two toes on each foot. One kick from one of their powerful legs could be big or incredible. We do have some construction going on over on the right side of the drain hose. The directional station for the Skyride is under repair. So obviously the Skyride is closed for annual maintenance. I do apologize for any inconvenience. And we're about to come into the Congo train station, ladies and gentlemen. This would be where you would want to get off the train to visit Congo, Antopia, or Jungala areas of the park. Now, Jungala is home to those magnificent tigers. Even the white tigers are there. As we do come into the station, though, please remain seated until the train comes to a full and complete stop. I'll be sure to let you know when it is safe to exit to that platform side of the train. Are planning on getting off here, please watch your head and your step as you exit to that platform side. Station exits will be on each end of the station, all the way up to your right and back here to your left as you step off on the platform. Folks, even if you're just changing your seating row, please do not step out the other side of the platform. Platform side only for your safety. Hold on just a few moments, folks. We are still rolling. Hold on, please. Easy, baby. All right, it is now safe to exit to the platform side. Again, my name is Ray. As you see, Mr. Ringling is out there with a big bell. As we pull away from the station, folks, do me a big favor. We're pulling to the left side of the train. Give a big wave to Nathan, our station master out there. All together in a big loud voice, everybody say, goodbye, Nathan!
Goodbye, Nathan!
Thank you so much. We do appreciate your enthusiasm. Nathan is indeed our hardworking station master. Here at the Congo station today. If you stay aboard, you'll see his smiling face again in about 35, 40 minutes. See you later, Nathan. Translation for the word Pumbaa actually means roar. Now, they did design that coaster to make that pretty loud roaring noise on purpose. Pumbaa carries you 143 feet up in the air. It'll travel about 60 miles an hour, and it'll flip you upside down 7 times or so. Located here in the Congo area, along with the Ubangabanga above the cars, the Congo River, the Bayless.
Speaking of the rapids, coming up on the right side of the train will be a clearing in the bushes. We may catch a glimpse of one of those Congo River rapids rafts floating by. The three-floating circular rafts will hold up to 12 people. It'll travel about a quarter mile right to the mouth of the Congo River through the rapids and waterfall. Most likely you are going to get a little bit wet on that ride, guys, but you could get totally soaked. Great way to cool off on a hot day, though. Congo River rapids. Coming up on the left side of the train will be Jungala. Stay seated, please. Stay seated. Jungala is where you'd go to visit those magnificent tigers. Even the white tigers were there. For those of you on the left side of the train, and you get right by that concrete wall, look up above it. You'll likely see about a dozen or so bats just hanging around for the day. They're called flying foxes, just a big old fruit bat. On a 5.5-foot wingspan when fully open. Also there in Jungala, two rides, the Wild Surge and the Jungle Flyers, a mini zipline-like ride. Treetop Trails is an area where children can climb through tubes, tunnels, and bridges made of ropes way up in the air. And the Jungle Bistro restaurant is there in Jungala as well. Building over to the left side of the train, ladies and gentlemen, there's Ambient Smokehouse located here in San Diego. That is where you would go to enjoy those delicious smoked barbecue ribs, chicken, brisket, or pulled pork, along with your favorite soft drink. And for those of age who do have alcoholic beverages available. And we are coming into the Snapperville station. This, of course, is where you'd want to get off the train to visit Stanleyville, but also to go down to Sesame Street Safari Park, the bird gardens, or the walkabout way where you can actually be the kangaroo or the wallaby, or if you wanted to go back to Jungala we just passed by. This would be the station you'd want to exit the train to visit those areas of the park. As we do come into the station, though, please remain seated until we come to a full and complete stop. I'll be sure to let you know whenever it's safe to exit to that platform side of the train. If you do plan on exiting here, please watch your head and your step as you exit to that platform side. Station exits will be on each end of the station. It'll be all the way up to your right or back here to your left as you step off to the platform. And folks, even if you're just changing your seating row, please do not step out the other side of the train. Platform side only, please, for your safety. That's Mike, our station master, waving us in out there. Hi, Mike. Hang on just a moment, guys. All right, it is now safe to exit to the platform side. On the left side of the train, give a big wave to Mike, our station master. All together in a big loud voice, everybody say goodbye, Mike. Woo-hoo! Thank you so much. I know he heard that. Good job, guys. Thank you again for your enthusiasm. Mike is indeed our hard-working station master here today. Hey guys, that big red blue one for roller coaster all around us out there is the Sheikra. And if you didn't know, hey, Sheikra takes you 200 feet up in the air at a 45-degree angle. Once you get all the way up at the top, it's going to bring you around and kind of sort of hang you over the edge for just a few seconds. Then it's going to let you drop nearly straight down at a 90-degree angle at speeds reaching 7 miles an hour. 70. If that's not enough, there is a second drop of about 138 feet. That one will take you down to an underground tunnel, brings you up and around to a watery splashdown. Now the riders do not get wet during that splashdown, but the folks standing on the sidelines watching you will get soaked. The shape is named after an African boss
So that'll break 42 hours when we do this break.
Next up on the right side of the train, ladies and gentlemen, the Scorpion roller coaster. Scorpion is the oldest roller coaster here at Busch Gardens presently. It features a 360-degree loop and travels 55 miles an hour. And that's an excellent coaster for the younger riders, or for those that haven't yet started riding coasters. The height requirement for the Scorpion is only 42 inches. That is in Vandopia, which also happens to be home to Falcon Fury. Look over to the right side of the train, folks. You'll see 32 of our guests going straight up right now. Now they go up 335 feet. Just as they near the top, it's going to tip them forward, facing straight down at the ground, and then drop them straight down at about 60 miles an hour. Pretty exciting ride, Falcon Fury, located there in Vandopia. Vandopia also has the Dragonfire Brewery. Showtime's a portion on the back of the wall now. The building now to the right side of the train is the Vandopia Theater. They also have a show there. It's called Opening Night Theaters. Very fun animal show, many of which are rescue animals from around the country. And again, Showtime's a portion on the back of your wall now. We also have a new show up at the Mall and Coliseum near the front of the park. That's Nathan, our station master over at Congo, giving us a big wave. Be sure to wave back. Hi, Nathan! Bye, Nathan! As we cross the service road out here, we're going down on to the Staring Getty Belt. And please keep in mind, the animals out here are, in fact, wild animals. They are free roaming, so we never know where they'll be or what they'll do. And they always have the right of way. So once again, it is extremely important to remain seated at all times, keeping all body parts inside the train. Of course, you may take as many pictures as you would like, but please do that from the seated position only. Thank you very much. Hold on to your cat. It's a bit... to the right side of the train, folks. I didn't think he was out there, but he is. Check out that reddish-brown animal with those huge horns on his head. That is a Watusi cattle. They were owned by wealthy Watusi tribesmen and used for their milk, sell them for their meat. That's because the tribesmen's wealth was measured by the number of live animals he kept. Black and white bird out there to the left up on the hill, and it's one of our Saddleville sports. And in the distance to the left, one of our female redneck ostriches out there. Way over to the left, you'll see several zebras. Those are Grant's zebras. Another one of our female redneck ostriches lying down out there. In the pond to the left, a couple of our mute swans swimming around out there. A couple of you may have seen some white rhino way out to the left. 4,000 to 6,000 pounds apiece when full grown. On the bend here over to the left on a little island by himself is our black rhino. They're about half the size, only 2,000 to 3,000 pounds apiece when full grown. There he is. Up on the hilltop to the left, reticulated giraffes. 18 feet tall for the male when full grown, weighing up to 1 ton apiece. They are one of the few animals to perceive color. They also have a 360-degree field of vision because of the way their eyes are located on their heads. Cute little tan animals on the hilltop to the left, a female impala. Then over to the right side of the train, the green and gold roller coaster track is brought up to Cheetah Hunt. It is a triple launch coaster, three launch positions throughout the track. The track is a bit over 4,400 feet long. That ride will take you 0 to Cheetah in about 2 to 3 seconds, Cheetah being 60 miles an hour, approximately. Somewhere on the left side of the train, we may catch a glimpse of a couple of Nyala antelope out there. There'll be large tan antelopes, thin stripes up and down their sides. Usually quite shy, they love hanging out in these tall bushes and grasses over to the left. Going back to the right side of the train, the Asian elephant display. And right across from the Asian elephants, the first building on your right is the Animal Care Center. They actually have a surgical suite in that building. If you've ever watched Saturday morning ABC television, they have a show called Wildlife Docs. It is actually filmed right here at Busch Gardens and right there in the Animal Care Center. The second building on the right coming into the Nairobi area is the Serengeti Outpost. And that is where you can book several of those behind-the-scenes tours. They're called Insider Tours. And they are separate ticketed events. If you do want to stop by, check out pricing and availability. See if there may be something of interest to you there. One of those tours actually takes you into the underground bedrooms of the tigers of Pinjantala. We're now coming into the Nairobi station, ladies and gentlemen. This is the nearest train station to the very front of the park, the entrance and exit as well, but also Morocco and Egypt areas. As we do come into the station, though, please remain seated. As we do come into the station, please stay seated until we come to a full and complete stop. I'll be sure to let you know when it is safe to exit to the platform side of the train. If you are planning on getting off here, please watch your head and your step as you exit to that platform side. Station exits will be on each end of the station. Hang on just a few moments, folks. We are still rolling. Stay seated, please. Stay seated. Hold on. All right, it is now safe to exit to the platform side.